Okay, hello students, welcome to your online class for EBS, and we are, as you know, we are revising for our half yearly syllabus. So we have covered from chapter number 1 to chapter number 6. Okay, so today I will be taking chapter number 7, 8 and 9. I hope you have taken out your books and notebooks. Okay, so we will be focusing more on revising, okay, rather than commenting and taking your answers. Okay. So I will be taking starting from chapter number 7. Please get ready, okay? And please tell me if my voice is clear to you all. Let me open the document now. Okay, if my voice is clear, okay, thank you, Vandika. Okay, I got your answer. So let us start with our chapter number 7 from the window. Okay. Okay, very good. So let us start from the window, chapter number 7. See, first I will be taking some key points and the question answers, and then I will ask some questions, then only answer. Okay, no need to answer. Okay, no need to comment more, rather than try to understand and underline what I am telling you to focus. Okay, so the first point here is Madgaon is a city in Indian state of Goa. Okay, so we have learned that was a station also when there was Humana's journey, and chapter 7 was related with Humana's journey. That was chapter number 6. Okay, that I have covered that in previous video. So now from the window, here is the station that is mentioned, Madgaon. It is a city in Indian state of Goa. Okay, let us move to the next point here. So there is a level crossing that you can see. So that level crossing, okay, what is a level crossing? A level crossing is a place where a railway line and a road meet each other on the same level. Okay, so just underline, railway line and a road meet each other on the same level. I hope that is clear to you all. Let us move further. There are people usually waiting on both sides of the crossing for the train to pass. Next topic we are taking today is bridge. So here in this picture you can see there is a bridge, and you have to understand that a bridge is a structure usually built over the rivers, canals, roads, etc. for easy movement of people and vehicles. So you can just remember structure built over the rivers, canals and roads. This is for definition, and what is the requirement for that? For easy movement of people and vehicles. Always remember that. Obviously if there is a bridge or tunnel, it is easy for easy movement. Okay, so that will be helping us for easy movement. Let us see again the next topic. Here is a tunnel I was talking about. So you can see a tunnel here. A tunnel is an underground passage usually built through a hill or under a road or river. Okay, so as you can see this, there is a train coming, and you can see this is a tunnel. When we go inside a tunnel, what do you think it is? It is dark all around. Okay, when we go inside that tunnel, it will be darkness. Okay, there will be darkness. Okay, so I hope that is clear to you. Let us see the next point. The route from Goa to Kerala has a total of 2000 bridges and 92 tunnels, as there are many water bodies and mountains. So there are a lot of water bodies and mountains in the route of from Goa to Kerala. Okay, just underline this, and has a total of 2000 bridges and 92 tunnels. So why it is so? Because there are so many water bodies and mountains to be covered. Okay, Udupi. So it is an important question. Udupi is a city in Indian state of Karnataka. Okay, Udupi is a city in the Indian state of Karnataka. So that is very much clear to you all. Nothing difficult in that. Okay, yes, Devansh got it. Okay, Google. Okay. So let us come to some languages that we can understand here. Okay. So Malayalam language is spoken mainly in Kerala. You see, you can just focus what I have done in this file. Malayalam is bold letters, okay, and Kerala is also written bold letters. Why? We have to understand Malayalam, Kerala. So Malayalam language is spoken mainly in Kerala. Similarly, Konkani language is spoken mainly in Goa. See, there are very important languages here mentioned in your book. So these five are very important. Okay, so please remember them all. There is nothing difficult. When we talk about Marathi language, this is very much easily recognizable. Why? Because Marathi Maharashtra is usually very much known to everyone. Okay. Okay. Yes, Mridul. Okay. Anushka is asking what we have to underline. Anushka, I told you when there are languages, you have to underline the language and the state, like I have done, like in Malayalam and here. Okay. Konkani, Goa, Marathi, Maharashtra, Gujarati, Gujarat. And this is very easy. Gujarati, Gujarat. There is nothing difficult. You don't even have to remember that. Even you don't have to write. Even if you see this Gujarati, you have to just mark Gujarat as your answer. Very easy. Okay. So next here is Kannada language is spoken mainly in the state of Karnataka. So always remember that this is the language in the state. Please remember that. No need to just write again and again and learn all the lines. Just mainly focus on the language name. Malayalam, Kerala. We need to go up like this. Okay, Karnataka, very good. Brother just got my point of division. Okay, Anirika, good. Right, Hashi. Okay, no need to now comment. Please come here on point 7. So, here it is about Malayalam language. Mother's elder sister is called Valiyamma. Okay, so here you have to just remember mother's elder sister is called Valiyamma. Mother's mother is called Amuma in Malayalam. But what if I ask you, mother's mother is called Dash? Not in Malayalam. In general, I am asking. In Hindi, you can write. What will you do? Amuma, Amuma? No. You have to just commonly write the name that you are talking, okay, that you are using for your mother's mother. Okay, you can write that name. Please understand that carefully. Yes, the man's word, Rani, that was right. Okay? So, it is in Malayalam that I am talking about, but if it is not written in Malayalam, then you can use the name of your mother's mother, what you call them, okay? With your own choice. So, let us see point number 8. Kottayam is a city in Indian state of Kerala. Now, underline Kottayam and then underline Kerala, so that you just remember Kottayam is a place or city in Kerala. Understood? See, I have made a little easier for you that it is in dark and it is in dark. So that is, you have to underline that. I hope that is all clear to you. So I hope I just come to the next point. Okay, so let us just revise again. Where is Madgaon? Madgaon is a city in Indian state of Goa. Okay. Madgaon is a city in Indian state of Goa. Yes, Samriddhi, very good. Okay, Athar, this is right. Just focus on the question now. Okay, name two vehicles which run on petrol. Okay, this is for reference I have written there. Motorcycle, car, okay. So these are usually common vehicles that run on petrol. But you can use any other vehicle to write scooty, this will be, that will be also correct. No problem in that. Okay, so that is a very easy question. Let us come to question number 3 here. Mother's elder sister is called Valiyamma in Malayalam. I have just told you that, okay, and this is an easy question. Okay, next question, what do you call your mother's mother? Now here it is a question I have told you just, okay. What do you call your mother's mother? Not in Malayalam, in normally I am asking, generally. You will say Nani, okay, this is correct, Nani is here in your answer. Okay, Yuvan says I have gone to Madgaon station, okay Yuvan. It is good. If the question comes, you can write that very easily. Good. Okay, Sahaj Janini. Now please focus. Name two vehicles that which run on diesel. So, for diesel, you can use truck, you can use write bus, okay, because they run usually on diesel. You can also write car also, because car, there are cars that are running on diesel as well as on petrol. So there is nothing like confusion of that point. Cars are there that runs on diesel and petrol both. Okay, no problem with that. So for your easy learning, truck and bus will be easy for you. Let's see question number 6. Write two means of transport of your choice. This is a simple question. Okay, what are transport? You just write boat, you write ship. Okay, if anybody is writing cruise, this is also correct, no problem with that. Okay, air transport, airplane, helicopter. Okay, so this is nothing difficult. Please come to the 7th question. Fill in the blanks. So here is the point 1. The level crossing is a place where a railway line and a road meet each other on the same level. See, I told you, okay, about that, where a railway line and road meet each other on same level. If you remember that question, we have already discussed that. Okay, just 4 minutes. Again, an easy question. This is again a revision question. Mother's mother is called Amma in Malayalam. Nothing difficult. Okay. Let us come to the next point here. Bridges are structured built over river, canals, roads, etc. for easy movement of people and vehicles. So as I told you before, this is for easy movement, so that people and vehicles can go here and there. Okay, cross place to one place to another. Clear to you? Okay, I hope that's almost clear. Let us come to the next question here. So there are 2000 bridges and 92 tunnels in the route from Goa to Kerala. Okay, so that has been discussed already. And why so? Because there are so many water bodies and mountains. Okay. Now again, complete the language. So language here, where it is spoken. Malayalam, Kerala, okay. Konkani, Goa. This is again, I am discussing, but it is already done. Okay. So even today I am telling you that question almost second time. Okay. Nothing difficult in that. Marathi, Maharashtra. So we are here on the left, there is language, and state on the right. So Marathi, Maharashtra. Gujarati, Gujarat. This is very easy. Kannada, Karnataka. Okay. So nothing difficult in that. Now come to question number 16.1. We should switch off engine while waiting at the level crossing. Obviously, there is no point of just polluting the environment. Okay, so we should be switching off the engine because it will be causing smoke. Okay, it will be causing noise pollution. So better, so we should switch off the engine while waiting at the level crossing. So this is a true statement. Remember that. Next statement here is, Kottayam is a city in Indian state of Kerala. Okay, suppose if I ask you, in place of Kottayam, I am asking Kozhikode is a city in Indian state of Kerala. Is it true? Please tell me. Now I am asking the question, you can write in comments. Is Kozhikode a city in Kerala? Tell me. Is Kozhikode a city in Kerala? I am asking a question, children. So I hope that you are getting my question. Okay, Arya and Anushka and Sayaj are saying true. Okay, good. Kozhikode is a city in Kerala. This is correct. Okay, so I just asked you and I just showed you Okyathar and Samriddhi, Sayaj, Arya and Good. Pragya not false, it is true. Kozhikode is in Kerala. Okay. Yes, okay, Anurika and Prasanna Tasmika. Okay. Now please stop commenting and I got your answers in presence also. So here is next question. Udupi is a city in Gujarat. So it is a false statement. There is the answer. Just tell me in comment section where is Udupi. Where is Udupi? Please write in the comment section. Okay, Mridul, please write your answer for the present question. Where is Udupi? Devansh, Udupi is not in Gujarat. Let me see who is going to answer that question. Okay, Devang says Karnataka. Very good. Devang says right now. So, Devang says Karnataka. Sehar says Karnataka. Okay, good. Okay, Abni, not Karnataka. It is Karnataka. Okay, Abni, please correct your answer. Yashika Jain correct. Anushka was correct. And Himani correct. Arvind correct. And Prakhar Sharma, not Kerala. It is in Karnataka. I am talking about Udupi. Okay, Shivesh Samridhi, good. Devang. Good, Devang, good. Shivesh Karnataka, okay, right, you spelling correctly. Okay, Vidur Pragya, not correct. Okay, Nikita, correct. Okay, so I hope that is all clear to you. Please now focus on the question next. So, if there is any doubt regarding chapter number 7 from the window, please write your doubts. I will take them. Okay, so if there is any doubt, you can write your question. I will be telling you the explanation. Otherwise, I am going to question number 8. 1 minute for all of you. Okay, Rishi. Okay. If there is any doubt, please tell me. See, Udupi, we have told that it is not in Gujarat, it is in Karnataka. So please tell me if there is any doubt. Okay, Ashika Jain, no doubt. Okay, Pratika, no doubt. That is okay. No doubt, okay. So, I am starting next chapter. Okay, yes. So, Anushka is saying, I have problem in languages. Anushka, as I told you, let us come back to languages. This is the language we are talking about. We have to see that on the left side there are languages and on the right side there are states. Okay? Anushka, I hope you are listening to me carefully. Now, here you just write carefully. Malayalam here, I have highlighted the state. You can also highlight that the state is Kerala where Malayalam is spoken. Okay. Okay, so what others out there? Let me take. Okay, Vandita. That's okay. And Konkani in Goa. And Marathi. Again, that is in Maharashtra. Gujarati is very easy. I told you it is indeed in the name itself that it is of Gujarat. Okay. Yes. Okay. So Kushan says he wants to know about level crossing. Okay, Kushan, let me just show you the level crossing once again. Okay, let us have a look again at the level crossing for Kushans. Okay, so let us please clear your doubt. Here you can see that it is a place where a railway line and a road meet each other at on the same level. Okay, so here you can see that people are waiting for the train to pass. Okay, Kushans, are you getting my point? And please tell me it is clear or not. Okay, Anushka says that it's clear. Okay, Anushka, good. You understand that? Okay, Kushans, is your doubt clear after seeing this picture? Please tell me, then I will be taking the next chapter. Okay, Shan says yes. So let us move on to the next chapter number 8. So here comes chapter number 8. Reaching grandmother's house. Okay, so children, as you all know, that we have been in this journey from chapter number 6, Kumana's journey, then chapter number 7 from the window, and chapter number 8, reaching grandmother's house. Okay, so this is a point which is very interesting, that these all three chapters are dealing with the Kumana's journey. So here it is, we have to learn some key points. Okay, key points of the lesson here is, first, bus conductor. So a bus conductor is a person who collects fare from the passengers. Why we have taken this question? Because Omana has travelled in the bus at that time when we were reading chapter number 8, reaching grandmother's house. Okay, I hope you all remember that. Okay, Devang is saying that, explain tunnel again. Okay, Devang, you must have said that before. Okay, let me just show you again. Okay, see, look carefully. You have to understand that it is an underground passage. Okay, Devang, please look carefully and that chapter will be ended after that. Devang, this is a word tunnel. It is an underground passage. Okay, by main underground passage, it is a way. Okay, that will be underground. And when you go inside, it will be all around darkness here. Okay, so built, usually built through a hill or under a road or river. Under a road or river and built through a hill. I hope that is clear to you. It is an underground passage, means there is an underground way, and when you go underground, you just see and look at this picture from where the train is coming. You can just easily think that when you go inside, when you go inside, you will be not seeing anything. Okay, Devang, I hope that is clear. Now please come back to our chapter number 8. So here I told you about bus conductor. Okay, who collects fare from the passengers and send tickets. Next here is, you can check amazing view of that boat, and this is ferry. Okay, so here you can see ferry, and many people are taking the ride of that ferry. So ferry is a boat. Okay, so it is a boat. First of all, important thing, underline boat. It is a boat which carries passengers across a water body. Obviously, see, boat is a water vehicle, so it is carrying passengers across a water body. Not at all difficult. It is, you must remember that. Okay, second thing, it is used by people to cross the water body and reach the other side. Obviously, when we are going some other side, that is why I am using, why we just use the boat on coming for same side. So it is for other side. I hope that is clear. Okay, yes, Anurika, bus conductor collect our tickets and collect our fare and sell tickets. Next question is fishing. So third question here, you can write, you can check that it is fishing. Fishing is the activity of catching fish for food or as a sport. Okay, you have seen a lot of fishermen. Okay, they are, and even normal people also, they are using their activity, using this activity of catching fish for either for food, okay, or as a sport. Some people love fishing, so they just use it as a sport. I hope that is clear to you. Okay, let us come to point 4, information on train tickets. So there is a photo of train ticket, okay, and I can just tell you here, this ticket, you can just see the PIR number, the train number, the date, the distance, okay, in kilometers, how much adult are there, how much child are there, how many adults and children are there, okay. So the coach number, this is here, just focus here, coach number, seat number, okay, birth, lower, middle, or whatever it is, age, okay, that can be seen. Here 2578 only, this is a fare, okay, fare is the rupee, fare in rupees, you can see. So children, you have to understand that there are a lot of things that we can check from the train ticket. Are you getting my point? So you have to learn all these things. If I ask you that, you have to just write, okay, there is a doubt, he is saying, Shubh. Shubh is asking, sir, what is a PNR number? So Shubh, PNR number is passenger's name record. Okay, just understand passenger's name record. And you just understand that when we are talking about PNR number, the passenger name record. What does that mean? The information of the passenger. Suppose if you are having your PNR number, it will be having you as a passenger and your name, show, and your record, your age, okay, your seat, your birth, okay. Birth, I'm talking about lower birth or middle birth or upper birth, okay. It's about train's birth. I hope that is clear to you. Okay, Anurika, your PNR number doubt and Yuvansh, that has been done, I think. Okay, PNR number doubt has been cleared. I hope it is all clear to you. So, PNR, if you know, if you want to know, it's the passenger name record. Okay. Let us come back to the next topic. So, just write here. You can just, for example, I have mentioned here, PNR number you can get from train ticket, train number, date of the start of journey and distance in kilometer. Very easy to know. You can just write any of this. Passenger detail, right? So you got my point. Passenger details I just mentioned. Okay. So coach number 6 and point number 7 is seat and berth and fare. Fare is the cost of the ticket. So if there is a question, what is the fare? You can write the cost of the ticket. Okay. I hope that is all clear to you. Let's come back to railway timetable. So children, a railway timetable gives details about the route of every train. Okay, so when there is a railway timetable, So the route of every train, the stations along that road. Suppose you are going on a train journey, you are starting from Kota. So when you reach the Kota station, you can just see there is a display of railway timetable, and you can just go to the chart or you can just check the railway timetable where there are trains going to Mumbai, to Delhi, to Lucknow, to UP. There are a lot of states, there are a lot of trains. Okay, so we can get the information what time they are going, okay, when they will reach, when they will leave the station, distance covered, etc. Okay, but where can we buy the railway timetable? We can buy a railway timetable from a railway station. Not at all difficult. I hope that is clear to you. Let us do some questions now from chapter 8. What is fishing? Fishing is a sport of catching fish for food or sport. Correct. Okay, not, we have done already. What is ferry? A ferry is a boat which carries passengers across a water body. We have done that already. Right, 5 information we can get from a train ticket. This has been already done just now. Okay, name 4 vehicles of your choice. When I have written of your choice, that means it is up to you. You can write aeroplane, whatever it is. When it is mentioned vehicles, whatever it is, bicycle, scooter, bus, car, truck, tractor, whatever it is. You, if I am asking your choice, then you can write of your choice. Okay? Okay. Okay, Anushka. Let us see, right, 4 places in which we need to buy tickets to enter it. So there are some places when if we want to go to that, we need to buy tickets. Okay, like zoo. When you go to a zoo, you have to buy a ticket. Okay, when you are watching a cricket match, you will go to cricket stadium and buy cricket match tickets. Okay, cinema hall. When you want to go to a want to watch a movie, okay, you are going to cinema hall or movie theater. Then again, you are buying tickets. Amusement parks also, water parks, amusement parks, you have to buy tickets to take the rides. So I hope that is clear, nothing difficult. Question number 5, a railway timetable gives details about the route of every train timing distance in kilometer. See children, this question again I have taken almost 3rd time today. So I don't think there is any confusion in that. Okay, what is, it is a railway timetable that gives details about every train timings and distance. A bus conductor collects fare from the passenger. The first question I have told you, this is the just revision of that. Ernakulam town station. Here it is important to underline this. Ernakulam town station is in Kerala. Kozhikode is in Kerala. Okay. Udupi is in Karnataka. Okay. Like this. So these questions can come. Rippling. Okay. When you throw a small like stone or something, you will see ripples have been made in water. Okay. Or surface of water, you can see. Okay, so that is rippling. Small waves on the surface of water. Okay, now let us come to chapter number 9. Please tell me if there is any doubt. I am starting chapter number 9 now. Is there any doubt in chapter number 8? Please tell me if there is any doubt. 1 minute for that. Okay, Devansh. Okay, Aryan. Okay, I hope that all are very much clear with these concepts. So let us. Okay, Ashita, Anushka, and Vandana. Okay, Sharanya. Okay, sorry, Karthik. Okay, so let us now move to chapter number 9. So let us see what was in chapter number 9, changing families. There were some reasons. Okay, these 3 families have been changed. So let us first read about Nimni's family. So Nimni's families have been changed due to their great excitement in Nimni's family because of a new baby sister. Okay, their newborn baby sister has arrived. So that is the change in Nimni's family. Just remember that Nimni's family, new baby sister. Underline that. Okay. So let us come back. Here you can see that. Let us see Sering's family. So Sering's father received a letter from his office. Whose father? Sering's father. Okay, while he was promoted. He was being promoted. Now let us see. Please underline, he was being promoted and Sering's father. Okay. Then again, promotion. What do you mean by promotion? Promotion is the process in which employee moves to higher position. I told you example of suppose there is a vice principal, he will be getting promoted to post of principal. So this is the example you can see in the PPT, video file. So this is vice principal getting promoted. So point is moving to a higher position in a job. Okay. I hope that is clear. There is no network problem, Vartika. You can just reload your page. I can check from here. Let us see Nazmi's wedding. So Nazmi's wedding, there was great joy. Why? Because her elder cousin brother is getting married. Okay. Nazmi's wedding in there, her elder cousin brother is getting married. Okay. So there are many events. I have told you Haldi, Sangeet. Okay. Mehndi, there are a lot of performances, dance performances, singing, activities that take place in marriage or wedding. Bride. Who is a bride? A woman who is getting married. Okay. And she wears special clothes like lehenga odni on the wedding day. Okay. Nothing difficult. Come to the point number next. Bridegroom. I just told you about bride. Now I am telling you about bridegroom. So a bridegroom is a man who is getting married. He wears special clothes on the wedding day like sherwani. Okay. So they can wear a coat also. It depends on them. Okay. So I am just mentioning a word here, sherwani. Okay. No hard and fast rules. So there are changes in families. So there can be many reasons for changes in families. Let us see leaving of a family member for higher study. Suppose your brother or sister is going for US or UK for studying. So they are for any place. Okay. Like going to Delhi or any other place. So for higher studies, they leave the house, there will be a little change in your family. Again, transfer of a family member, your mother, father. Okay. So then again, there will be changes. Marriage, okay, etc. Birth of a person, death of a member. Okay. So there are a lot of reasons. You can mention any reasons that you want to mention about the changes in families. Let us see the next point, law on child marriage. So there is a law on child marriage. Let us understand that child marriage law has been fixed. The minimum age. Minimum age means that the age before that you cannot get married. Okay, so if I say there is a girl is marrying at 17 years, this is wrong. Why? It is punishable offense. So the minimum age, girl should be at least 18 and boy should be at least 21 years for marriage. So there is a law on child marriage. Okay, this is understandable by you. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Let us see some questions on chapter number 9. So the chapter number 9 questions are there. First question, repetitive in nature, what is the law on child marriage? Okay, I just told you the fixed age minimum for girls is 18. Let us underline it again. And for boys it is at 21 years. Understood? No point of confusion here. Girl at 18. Okay, Hardik Singh was very good and Devansh very good. No need to answer, please just come back to the question. Again, a revision question I am taking, right? Four reasons for changes in families. So there can be a lot of reasons for changes in families, like transfer of a member in a job place. Again, second is marriage of a family member, death of a family member, going for higher education. Very easy, all these four are very easy. Okay, let us move to the next question. Write a short note. Okay, so there can be question on short note also. You just write one or two lines here. Okay, a bride is a woman who is getting married. Okay, nothing difficult. She wears special clothes on the wedding day like lehenga odni. Okay, just underline lehenga odni for bride and underline sherwani for bridegroom. So if this question comes, you can just remember, okay, bridegroom is wearing sherwani. Just to mention for a short talk. Bridegroom is man who is getting married and bride is a woman who is getting married. Okay. Let us come to the next question. What is promotion? Promotion, please understand again, revision question. Promotion is a process in which employee moves to higher position in a job. Please underline this. Getting my point? Employee moves to a higher position in a job. You can also give example if you want. but at least remember this. So write four events that may take place during the wedding. I just told you haldi, sangeet, mehndi, dance performance, singing performance. Okay, a lot of things are there. You can write any of your choice. Okay, so question number 6, write the reason for changes in Nimmi's family. So Nimmi's family change was due to arrival of newborn baby sister. Please underline this. Nimmi's family was changed due to arrival of newborn baby sister. Okay. Sering's family. Come back to Sering's family now. Next point here is there were changes in Sering's family due to his father's promotion. Promotion of his father. Underline this in Sering's family. Okay, next point, Nazmi's family. So because her elder cousin brother was getting married, underline this. This is for your easy revision. If you have already learned that, that will be very much effective for you all. So I don't think there is any difficult thing because we have done these chapters almost 4 or 5 times. I don't think there is any point of confusion. Okay. Okay, so maybe okay, you watch. Next point, question number 7. A bridegroom is a man. Okay, there is a fill in the blank who is getting married. So bridegroom is a man. If there can be a question also, if I am asking bride, then bride will be a woman who is getting married. Woman who is getting married. Next, bride wears special clothes like lehenga on wedding day. Which day? Wedding day. Lehenga, wedding day, bride. This should be underlined. Sering's father received a letter from his office. Why? Because he was promoted. Okay, the promotion letter he received. Great excitement in Nimmi's family, newborn baby sister. Again, revision of that. Promotion is process in which employee moves to higher position. So here comes the end to this class also. Now here you are free to just ask any doubt you can ask. Okay, so this chapter, these 3 chapters have been completed. Please ask your doubts if you have any. Children, please listen carefully. If you have any doubts regarding this chapter, ask me. I am here to answer them. Okay, Devansh. Okay, Vartika. Okay, Arani. So, if everything is clear to you, should I end this class now? Okay, no doubt. Okay, Rishi. Okay. Vidur. Okay. Sahaj. Okay. Okay, Himani. Okay, sure. So, okay children, so try to practice more, try to learn, try to revise from your worksheets, try to revise from your notebooks, okay. When we learn with our question form, question and answer form, we will retain and revise better. Okay, there is nothing difficult in that. So, okay, I will try if I take again a revision session. Okay, I will try to revise all the 9 chapters again. Okay, if there is any class, although your half-year syllabus has been again completed, almost 5th or 6th time, I think. Okay. So, okay children, then bye. Have a wonderful day ahead. Bye.